Now, like many people who go to the pub on occasion, you end up talking a lot of cobblers.
Yes, just after 9 o'clock normally.
So we're talking deer cobblers.
Yes!
It's our venison cobbler.
The cut of meat that we're using is shoulder. I'm just going to trim this off, mate, and then dice it.
Now, one of the building blocks to stews all over the world is what chefs would call a mirepoix, and that's the mixture of diced carrots, onion and celery. But this is kind of pub food, so this is quite a hearty mirepoix. So for my purposes, we'll call it a maxipoix. So first off, we'll get the onions into some oil and get it to sweat nicely.
So what we're doing is, you see these pieces here? We're going to try and just trim those off because that's sinew. It will come down in the cooking time because we're going to cook this for about 1 hour and 3/4 to 2 hours. But I just like to take the really thick bits out.
There's a lot of onions there, but this is all going to drop down and it's going to be rich.
Now look, I'm keeping the meat in quite decent sized chunks. Now the reason for that is it cooks a long time and you really want to keep the kind of integrity of that meat. So when you do pop it in your mouth, you get a lovely chunk of this fabulous venison. It's a great product that we produce in the UK, venison. It's brilliant.
Carrots going. With venison, we get all the opportunities to put in things like bay and thyme, red currant jelly, mustard. You know, you can build up the sweet and savoury flavours. And now some celery. This is like young celery. What I would do is normally just strip off any stringy bits, just like so. And pretty soon, this is going to be sweating. It's going to be sweating like the darts team when it's going for double tops. I think we're there, mate.
Right, Mugger? Yeah.
So a couple of big tablespoons of flour goes in. And, you know, as I say, we want this to be rich and thick and hearty.
Lovely.
This is stonking good gravy, not a frugal jus.
Definitely, definitely not.
And let's have a teaspoonful of mustard powder in there as well.
Oh, lovely. Right, now, what I'm going to do is make sure that those veggies are all covered with this beautiful mix of flour and mustard. And that will form the thickening for the venison casserole.
Time for the beer.
Get in. Look at the colour of that.
Well, the beer's going to give it a lovely, dark, rich colour. In fact, it's probably too rich, so I think we need to put some water in as well.
A little bit of water. Look at that. Nice, decent chunks of venison. And then, Mr. Myers?
Well, venison, we can have some nice sweetness. So some red currant jelly, a couple of big spoonfuls of that, which again, and it's gonna give the sauce a lovely sheen as well as flavor. A couple of bay leaves. And some thyme. Just strip the leaves off, we don't want the sticks in. And we have stacks of black pepper. You do the salt king, you got a good taste for it.
Right, so now what we need to do is bring this to the boil.
And then we'll put it into a preheated oven at 180 degrees Celsius for a fan oven. And we'll leave it there for about 1 hour and 3/4 to 2 hours.
Right, let's get it in then, eh? Perfect.
The cobbler. It's the scone that thinks it's a cobblestone.
It does?
It does. We start off, I've got some self-raising flour in there, and we're rubbing the butter.
There's something nice about that, and then getting your hands in, dude, isn't
it? Oh, I remember my mother doing this.
Now, listen, what do you fancy? Should we keep them plain, or should we put something in them?
You can do what you want, but it's got to complement the dish.
Rosemary.
We've got some there.
Let's have it.
Kingy, should I cut out, and you want to finish these, so I'll go and clean my hands?
All right, mate, yeah.
Milk's measured, 300 mil.
Perfect. And just put all the milk in at once, in a little well in the middle. And then you very gently just form a dough. This dough is coming up really nice, man. It's so light and springy, really good. Beautiful. There you are, Mugger.
Thank you. and we just pat this. And, you know, for scones, we really wouldn't roll it out. So I'm gonna kind of break the habit of a lifetime, but just do it quite gently. We don't want to overwork your dough.
That has dropped, hasn't it?
Isn't it beautiful?
Oh, gosh, it's fruity, it's rich. The porter, the beer, really has added something to that. You can taste the yeastiness to it.
Tell you what, though, a little bit of lemon juice just to bring that richness up a little.
You need the lemon juice as well to cut through the sweetness and also the maltiness. Don't waste your mixture. We'll reform this.
So we'll start in the centre. And just work your way around.
Should we do half cobbles?
Oh, yeah, let's cool.
Yeah?
As they rise, they'll go really moist and unctuous on the bottom and really crisp on the top, because what we're going to do is we're going to brush them with a little bit of beaten egg. Right, now, I've just increased the oven temperature from 180 to 200, because these, we need to treat them a little bit like scones, so the oven has to be really quite hot.
Beautiful.
Stick that in the middle of the table. Everybody goes for it.
Every dish tells a story. It may be about the ingredients that define it, the memories it evokes, or the people who created it.
This is the story of Pete Tiley's ham, egg and chips.
My name is Pete Tiley. I'm the landlord of the Salutation Inn. Well, I grew up in Gloucestershire. I grew up just down the road. I ended up working in London for 8 years as a telecoms business analyst. It kind of wasn't quite what I wanted to do. I really loved pubs and beer, and so really kind of wanted to get into the beer and pub industry. My dad, who still lives in the area, phoned up and told me that the Salutation was up for sale. I quit my job and left London and, bought a pub. I always wanted this to be the very best pub that I could possibly create. I wanted it to be a traditional pub, which kind of reflects traditional pub values and traditional food and drink, specifically of the local area of Gloucestershire. We're in a village called Ham. We wanted to produce the very best ham that we possibly could, so we started keeping the pigs. We've got 8 pure Gloucestershire Old Spots. It's a breed that originated from this area in the Berkeley Vale. The fact that they live as happy, contented pigs in a nice, stress-free environment means that they are relaxed, and that affects the quality of the meat. It's kind of getting back to the simplicity of the ingredients, making sure they're really good quality and they're sourced correctly. We've got 9 hens. They're a mixture of different breeds. We've got some sort of interesting kind of rare breeds. We've got a Buff Orpington. We've got some cream leg bars, which lay the blue eggs. Because there's not too many, we kind of generally use them up pretty much every day, so the egg kind of turnover is nice and fresh, so you've got kind of nice yolks, they hold together well in the pan. It's great for customers to have eggs from our own chickens. They can come in, they can see how they've lived, they have a nice life. We grow our own spuds. Very rewarding to go into the garden, like turf them out the ground, out the soil, and then straight into the kitchens. Chips don't get a lot fresher than that. It's simple ingredients, but together they combine to make this the most amazing kind of taste sensation. You've got your hot chips, the cold ham, sort of saltiness of the gooey, rich egg. I love the simplicity of it. I love the fact it's a traditional pub meal.
It's nice to eat food that's grown, reared, cooked just a couple of miles from where you live. It's lovely.
And the taste is great. The taste really comes through. And you know what you're getting. You absolutely know, because it's produced just over the road.
This food has flavour. I wouldn't even attempt to find food because I couldn't.
Where you have a well-run community pub, you will have a much happier, healthier, better functioning society. So for me, it's really important that a pub acts as a hub for a local community and supports that community.